It's final time in Miami. We have two big hard-hitting women in the final. Elena Rybakina versus Kvitova. There can only be one winner. And here we go, a nice graphic of the first finalist, Elena Rybakina, who is in hot, hot form. She's just won Indian Wells, looking to complete the Sunshine Double, the big favourite in this matchup. And her opponent, if we just go down, is Kvitova, Petra Kvitova of the Czech Republic, an excellent player, someone who is generally very nice, who's been on the tour for some time. She's won handfuls of titles in the past. She's got all the experience, but let's see who's going to win. We will be covering the match tonight, and this is my preview. So first tweet I have is the head-to-head, and we have Kvitova here talking after her match on court, where she was saying, we've played two times, it's one all, so this is going to decide it tomorrow. So it's the big showdown in the final, only one winner, and they're going to have the favourable head-to-head. Of course, I did mention earlier, Rybakina is a massive favourite. I think the bookies have her about 1.3 with Kvitova over threes. So good money on Kvitova if you want to take a risk. The next tweet here is just some of Rybakina's form. So she's beaten Pegula in Miami. And now that means back-to-back finals in the Sunshine Double. Of course, she won Indian Wells. She extends her win streak to 13 matches. And I like this bit here because it's with the elegance of a princess and the spirit of a champion, Elena is bringing class back to tennis. She is an extremely likable character. She does have a lot of elegance. Not the way she plays, because she's a very hard-hitting, strong-serving young tennis player who is pretty brutal when it comes to rallies. She can finish you off with ease. There's not many players which can handle the power of Iga and give her some more, but this girl can. But the way she carries herself in the press room, she is very elegant. And it's hard not to root for her. I really do find myself in matches now backing her and wanting her to do really well and keep this run going, quite frankly. The next one we have here is from Miles, one of the commentators on the podcast, and he's saying one win away from the Sunshine Double or one win away from a 30th WTA title for Kvitova. And I like this one because it just illustrates how many titles Kvitova has won. 30 it would be for her if she can win this match. And of course, it means more for her as well because she will be back inside the top 10 in the rankings and top 5 in the race if she can win. It's not tomorrow, it is today. Hard not to be happy for such a nice person. So we're seeing her coming back to her best, getting inside the top 10. Good chance of playing in the WTA race come the end of the season in the WTA finals. And I think we're going to be in for a really exciting final. I've said how Rybakina is the big favourite. I think Kvitova has been excellent, beating some really tough opposition along the way. And I think this one is going to play out in the way most people see it happening, but it's going to be close. So I'm going to be going for Rybakina to win this match and to win the Sunshine Double, which goes with my bracket as well, because I did predict her at the start of the tournament. But I think it's going to be really tight. And I'm going to go with two tie breaks. Two tie breaks for Rybakina. She'll win both. And she will be lifting the title and the Sunshine Double. Anyway, that's my thoughts on the final. Make sure to join us for the live watch along. And let me know in the comments section below. Do you agree with me? Or do you think Kvitova can pull up a surprise? Let me know in the comments. And of course, if you haven't already, hit the like button and subscribe if you're new.